Welcome back to another video, everyone. So yeah, I'm gonna do one game at a time with each pack I have, for Switch Vita, which is my GameCube, and PS2 emulators I call for on my phone in case I play a game. Yeah, so here I am with Yeritza. So we're gonna talk about Crash Bandicoot, the Wrath of Cortex, right? On the GameCube emulator, which is what my gameplay is from. Man, never mind. This is not my gameplay. So, on to the story. Thanks. So we begin in a space station where Uka Uka expresses his disgust with the villains and their past doing. Cortex has a secret weapon he's been hiding in development, but he needs some progress. Uka Uka decides to release the elementals one by one as well. So yeah, this is not my gameplay on the PS2. In fact, I have it for GameCube and GameCube emulator, as well as I'm pretending I have it for the Switch Vita, right? Right, yeah. So, yeah. In fact, this is going to be a almost 20-minute one. So, get comfy, snack on some Wumpa Fruit, or chips, or crackers, or whatever, and grab a soda, or juice, or any type of drink. And let's talk about Wrath of Cortex, right? Thanks. Oh, and is it me, or do the elementals look awesome and the others look odd? Never mind. Back on Earth, there were natural disasters happening left and right, so yeah. Haku Haku decides to check whatever the heck is going on, and he meets up with his brother Uka Uka as well. See, he has released the so-called elementals. Yeah. How about that?
Yeah.
So, yeah. Let's talk about Wrath of Cortex one more time. This time for the GameCube emulate. This time for the Switch Vita, which is what I'm pretending my phone is in case I play games. Yeah. So, yeah. Hell, we don't even need a Steam Deck to play these games, right? Because it costs money, right? Right? So, yeah. Oh, and these boss fights are awesome. It's like Crunch taking Tiny, Engine, Dingle Dial, and Entropy's places.
Yeah.
But hey, if you're good, then you're good. So yeah, and Pura is there too, yeah. So none of this is my gameplay on the PS2. I borrowed it from someone else, you see? All this. So yeah. How about that? Oh, and there's a whole bunch of stuff to do in this game as well. Same as Crash 2 and 3, yeah. Oh, and you get to collect colored gems as well. Yeah, how about that? So, yeah. Oh, and once you've defeated a boss, you get to move on to the next gate.
Yeah.
Similar to Crash 3 and Crash 2, I guess, yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Oh, and you get to collect crystals, gems, and relics as well. Yeah. In which the sprint comes in handy. In fact, these loading times, like, they went on forever! At least, not on the GameCube. So, yeah. I got the GameCube. Got it on GameCube as well. Well, yeah, similar to Crash Team Racing on Switch, but they fixed that too. Yeah, how about that? So, yeah. Oh, and Crash Team Racing takes the lead, yeah? So, yeah. Oh, and how about that? And similar to by Blimps in Crash 3, yeah? So, yeah. Bamboozled, yeah? With these hamster wheels, which come in handy, yeah. So, yeah. Oh, and how about that? I am on a roll here. Yup, that's right. So, yeah, how about that? Oh, and once you completed 5 levels, you get to move on to the boss fight as well. In which boss 1 is Rocco and Crunch as well. And boss 2 is Wawa and Crunch as well. Yeah. And boss 3 is Pyro and Crunch. Crashes to ashes, yeah. Oh, and boss 4 is Optimistic Pressure. With Lolo and Crunch. Genie Crunch, yeah. So, yeah. We'll get to these boss fights later, so, yeah. These sneak shoes come in handy with nitro crates, yeah. How about that? I don't mind that as well. So, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Oh, and you get characters get to talk to you in the warp room as well, yeah. How about that? So, yeah. Oh, and there are voice actors like Arlie Ermy, who voices Wawa, and Rocco, voiced by Thomas F. Wilson, who plays Biff in Back to the Future. Oh, and by the way, Arlie Ermy also voices Sarge in Toy Story. Yeah. Oh, and Pyro is voiced by Mark Hamill, who is Luke Skywalker and the Joker, many others, yeah. Oh, and Lolo is the Air Elemental, voiced by Jess Harnell, who will make his debut in Crash Tag Team Racing, but we'll get to that another time. So, yeah. Oh, and you better watch out for these lizards as well, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. Oh, and this is when I don't have the red gem yet, so, yeah. PS2 version, you'll have to use the bazooka, while the GameCube version, you're gonna have a bad time with it being far away. So you're gonna have to use your super spin as well. Death Tornado spin, yeah. How about that? And a slide as well, yeah. Oh, and that sinking feeling as well can be tough sometimes, but I don't mind that. It's good. Pretty good, yeah. Oh, and there's also H2O No as well, yeah. How about that? Oh, and once you completed these levels, you get to go to Drain Damage. How about that? So, yeah. Oops. So yeah, how about that? Oh, and be careful not to fall in the water as well, yeah. How about that? Or get hit with these trophy attacks, yeah. Which is a pain in the ass thing to do, yeah. So yeah. Oh, and yeah. I found that tough sometimes, yeah. So yeah, how about that? Try not to fall in the water, or else you'll lose a life as well, yeah. Hey, I did it. I got the double jump, yeah. And I got it on the GameCube emulator as well. Oh, and with it, you also get the Wombat code. And the gauntlet, you get the purple gem as well. Yeah, in a secret area, right? So, yeah. Oh, and so, yeah, I completed this game 100%. Back then on PS2, yeah. Push you. One crate, yeah. So, yeah. Oh, and there's Tsunami as well with scooter riding Coco as well, yeah. How about that? Oh, and none of this is my gameplay on the PS2, yeah. So I borrowed it from someone else, you see? And this is similar to the motorcycle levels in Crash 3, yeah. So, yeah. Oh, and there are obstacles as well, yeah. How about that? These Jeep levels, yeah, how about that? Oh, and so, yeah. Like I said, how about that? Oh, and there's a whole bunch of stuff to do in this game as well. Yeah. In Eskimo Roll, like avoid Troopy, Dingle Dial, and of course, Tiny Tiger. Yeah. How about that? How about that? So, yeah. Oh, and there's a whole... Sadly, no Dr. Engine appearance as well. In these hamster ball levels. Yeah. How about that? Sorry. Yeah. Oh, and next stop is... Yeah. Oh, and Fahrenheit Frenzy as well, yeah. In which you use a helicopter pack thing, yeah. Oh, and next up is the boss with Pyro and Crunch. Crashes to Ashes, yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Oh, and you get to use this water gun on Crunch as well. Fire Crunch, yeah. How about that? Oh, and you better watch out for these doubles at the end. The third round, yeah. How about that? You better watch out for them coming towards you, yeah. Oh, hey, look at that. They did it. Oh, and next up is Avalanche with snowboard riding Coco running away from Avalanche. Yeah. How about that? So, yeah. How about that? Sorry. Everything's all good now. Next up is Droid Void. Yeah, that's right. And next, in which Crash can ride a mech. And next up is Spaceship Riding Coco. Then, in Crash Droids. Coral Canyon. Then, Weathering Heights. And then, Optimistic Pressure. Which is a crap version of Engine's boss battle in Crash 3. So yeah, I don't mind that, yeah. Especially on the GameCube. Yeah. I already talked about it back then with Angelina on the GameCube, so I'm gonna talk about it again. One more time on the Nintendo Switch Vita, which is what I have this on my phone on emulator, which is what I'm pretending is my... Here's my Nintendo Switch Vita as well. Yeah, how about that, right?
Yeah.
So yeah. Oh, and this bazooka comes in handy as well. And crash and burn. Yeah. How about that? Oh, and yeah. Next up is Gold Rush, where you get the yellow gem, as well as Crash and Burn, you get the red gem. And next up is the Hamster Ball rolling, another Hamster Ball rolling levels in medieval times, yeah. So, yeah. Oh, and you better watch out. So yeah, you get to ride a mech as well and run. Next up is Cortex Vortex, right? Yeah. So yeah, once you've completed all the levels, you get to take on Cortex, Uka Uka, and Crunch. So yeah, Rocco throws meteors. And you get to use a bazooka to shoot down Cortex as well, yeah. Wawa sends an ice, yeah. So yeah, how about that? She's coming right back, yeah. Pyro goes in fire beneath your feet, and you better watch out for these lasers, which Lolo sends in, yeah. How about that? So yeah. So yeah, how about that? Oh, and it's a very awesome fight as well, yeah. And when this is the bad ending, you know. So yeah, she came back. So oh, and I got the blue gem. You see, you get the blue gem as well, and getting all the relics as well. Oh, and Crunch wakes up from a mind control, yeah, how about that? So yeah, we only got 2 minutes left, right? So yeah. Oh, and Cortex and Uka Uka are stranded in Antarctica in the end as well, and Crunch reunites with Crash and Coco. Yep, that's right. So yeah. Oh, and there's a whole bunch of stuff to do in this game as well. Yeah, like collect relics and you know. Collect the relics as well to unlock secret areas, secret levels, yeah. Oh, and that's Crash Bandicoot, the Wrath of Cortex on the GameCube emulator. And also for the Switch Vita, which is what I'm pretending my phone is for playing games, right? So, yeah. Once you completed the game 106%, you get to go back and play for fun, I guess, but who knows how long this takes, so I couldn't be bothered, yeah. So yeah, after all, yeah, like I said, none of this is my gameplay for the PS2, you see? So yeah, only get to hang like in Crash 2 and 3 as well, yeah. Is it worth playing? Yes, absolutely. Especially on the go, at the beach, in the car, and a relative's house, yet even parties. So that's all I have for this video. I hope you enjoy. Definitely subscribe if you're new here, and make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Comment and share if you like. So I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.